This guide will show you how to create and run FreeFileSync batch jobs. Let's start by opening an existing FreeFileSync configuration file and converting it to a FreeFileSync batch configuration. In this example, we will be running the batch job while we're still working at the same PC. So we'll let FreeFileSync show a pop-up dialog in case an error occurs. Since the batch job should run in the background and not divert attention while we're working, we choose Run Minimized. Saving log files is not important because we handle errors manually, but it doesn't hurt to leave them enabled. If the log folder is left blank, FreeFileSync will store the logs inside the FreeFileSync configuration directory, which can be found in the roaming profile of the currently logged in user. But even if log saving is turned off for batch runs, FreeFileSync always writes the most recent activity into the last syncs.log file, which can be found in the same directory. So it is always possible to reconstruct the last few sync operations in case something unexpected has happened. Let's save the batch job to the disk. The batch job is now ready to be used. To run it, just double-click on the configuration file. The first time you start a FreeFileSync batch job, Windows might hide it from the notification area. To change this default, locate the hidden progress icon and drag it down into the visible part of the notification area. If you want the progress window to move to the foreground, you can double-click on the FreeFileSync symbol anytime during synchronization, and minimize it again by clicking on the downwards pointing arrow. To make changes to an existing FreeFileSync batch job, right-click on the configuration file and select Edit with FreeFileSync. Then apply your changes and save them.